Hello, everyone. Hi. Good to see you. I'm Brad. Welcome to the Hard Rock New York. This is Audacy Live. It's very exciting for us. So, everybody, welcome James and Vance Joy.
Hey, buddy. Oh, nice change. Nice change.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
You know him. Nice to see you. How are things? Come on. Don't stand. I'm way too short for this. Now you have a new album that that I'm sure you're very, very excited about. What is it about this album that's so special for you?
It was just a new experience. You know, I'd written a couple of songs before, you know, the pandemic and kind of the way that life changed in that 2 year kind
the vacation
window. The vacation, yeah. So in that vacation I was I wasn't hit too hard by it, and I was living at home, and I did Zoom songwriting sessions. Like I did like a couple every month, and over those Zoom songwriting sessions I accumulated, you know, 12 songs, and I wasn't even really thinking, you know, I'm going to finish an album. It has to be done by this certain time. So it really was like taking its own time, and it was I was in a good rhythm, I think.
It's interesting that you were in a good rhythm and in a good headspace when the world is in such a perilous spot. Mm. How is that? Is it because, I mean, you spent some time in Spain, which that doesn't suck.
Yeah, that's a great place. I was living in Barcelona for probably about a year in the last 2 years, and I don't speak Spanish very well at all, so I wasn't reading the news. So I think that helps
because
I have no idea what's going on.
You didn't even think about that recipe.
Yeah, that's a good way. I'm not, you know, all good if you read the news, but I just didn't really have that option. You know, I didn't know what was going on. So I think that kind of kept, you know, I wasn't like getting too bummed out about stuff. I think I was, you know, living with my girlfriend. We were having, good times over there. So, yeah, I don't know. I think I was very fortunate, but. That definitely comes through in the songs. I think I was having a good time.
You write pretty personally, so I hate that this is too personal. Mm. Relationship going well?
Yeah, it's going good. She's here in town, so we had a great time, and I think that's you can write about love if you're in it or not. You know, it doesn't really make a difference to the. You know, you can write a great song anytime, you know. You don't have to be happy. You don't have to be sad.
You can. I can't do that.
Well, maybe you could. I don't know. But, you know, it's just everything's good. Yeah.
When you go to write a song that is a very vulnerable space and then it becomes about somebody in your life, that's you wrote a contract there. That's a contractual obligation.
Yeah, I think it's funny, like she with my girlfriend, she kind of like, if I write a song about her or it's even referencing her, she's like, she kind of wants it to be really specific. So if I don't say her name, she's like, this could be about anyone. Like, how do I know this is about me? So I, in one of the songs, I'm like, describe, you know, she's short brown hair, wearing a red jacket, all those kind of things. And she's like, okay, well, now I can really see myself in the song. But otherwise, she's like, this could be about anyone, you know.
It's Becky with the good hair.
Yeah, exactly. It's Becky with the good hair.
So the other thing that I noticed is... the amount of people who try to cover your songs on YouTube, it's astronomical. I don't know if you – do you take a stroll through all of the covers that are out there? You know, Riptide, of course, Missing Piece too.
Yeah, there's so many covers of Riptide on, like, social media and stuff, and I check them out every now and then. But the ones I check out, there's a guy that did a cover of, like, one of my first songs I ever released called Emmy Lou. He did a really good job, and there's another one I saw, actually it wasn't a cover, I was like kind of really happy to see on YouTube a guitar tutorial of one of my more recent songs called Don't Fade, and it was a guy like showing how to play it, and I watched that tutorial and I was like, oh cool, like that's he actually played it differently to me, and I was like it made me feel good that I was like, well, this dude is like put the time in to like learn my song, and they, you know, had like 1,000 views, but I was like, cool.
Somebody hire him. Yeah, he's got it going.
Yeah, he's good.
The one thing that the thing that interests me is, how does a kid that plays rugby and then goes to write? You start everything basically acoustically, right? But how do you get into the ukulele? Where does that come in? Ukulele, because there's not many kids walking around with a ukulele.
Yeah, there's a few more now, I think, because
Don Ho.
I know that like they're just Carla is doing well. That's the ukulele brand, but. I think I went to a random music shop one day and I had no intention of buying a ukulele. I was there for another reason, but at the counter there was a ukulele and it was just a random promotional ukulele. I bought it and I started playing it and I was like, this is cool. And then that was it. You know, it was just totally on a whim. It was probably just a way of kind of doing something slightly different at the start to, yeah, I was like, this is different. I'll mic this up and start playing a uke.
Yeah, when you start to rank the great ukulele players, you know, you have a George Harrison, you got a Don Ho, Tiny Tim.
Okay, yeah.
Where are you in the pantheon of the ukulele?
I think you're on
the Mount Rushmore of the ukulele?
I'm not like a pro at playing it, but I think I'm in the top four or five. I mean, you just said four people, so I'm in there. I'm in there somewhere. I'm not going to, you know, tell you where.
No, you don't rank them.
I don't want to sound arrogant, but I'm up. I'm
but
up
you're
there.
On the Mount Rushmore.
I'm on the Mount Rushmore of ukulele.
I'm very excited about the new album. I can't wait to see it perform live. You've got so many shows coming up. I can't imagine the sort of release and the feeling that it's going to emit, especially after, you know, a tour. It gets canceled and starts all over. That's got to be exciting, huh?
It's good, yeah. It's these last few shows have been really nice. Like we played at Pier 17 here in town a couple of nights ago, and that was really good. Like that was just a beautiful crowd and just good connection. So I think it'll be just more of the same, and it'll be nice for people to have heard the songs a bit as well, because we're playing a few new songs and people kind of are like, but they don't know the words yet. You know, they're kind of trying. You see people trying to figure it out in the that's moment, good. And they're like kind of mouthing, kind of, which is, I think that's amazing. So hopefully people will be singing along in the shows to come.
Well, I'm very excited. Vance Joy, James from Vance Joy, thank you for being here. We appreciate you.
My
thank
pleasure.
You.
Yeah. Thank you, man. Cheers. Yeah. Legend. All right, guys. Amplified. This is Kelly O'Donoghue, by the way. She's playing trumpet. Do you want to tell them about what happens when you burp in the trumpet? It goes flat. We were just talking in the car and we're like, have you ever yawned while you play trumpet? And she's like, sometimes, but you stop and you yawn. And she's like, but sometimes you burp. And when you burp while you're playing trumpet, it goes down. Yeah, that's what happens. So keep your ears out for the... I'm sorry to set you up like that, Kelly. It's like, we just stop. Yeah, I'll stop there. All right. Let's start with Fire in the Flood. Okay.
I was only walking through your neighborhood, saw your light on, honey, in the cold. I stood anywhere I go, there you are. I've been getting used to waking up with you. I've been getting used to waking up here. Anywhere I go, there you are. Anywhere I go, there you are. There you are. There you are. Anywhere I go, there you are. Boy, when you know, you'll know. And I know.
Thanks, guys. Alrighty. Let me just check the tuning. That feels about right. Does anyone have a guitar pick? I don't think I have one. Does Cal, do you have a guitar pick?
No. Oh, yeah, here we go.
You got, is it in my pocket? Are you like a magician? You're like, it's in your pocket. Thanks, Cal. Okay. I think this is pretty in tune. Ooh. It's that one. Sorry, guys. That doesn't sound. Down, down, down. That's F. F is the wrong note, yeah. Lucky I've got Kelly here because she's telling me that clearly I should be tuning to this note, okay? There we go. Yeah, that's about right. Yeah, okay. This is missing piece.
I've been waiting for the tides to change, for the waves to send you my way. I see you, darling, but you pixelate. It gets hard to take these days. But we'll hold the line, I won't let go, 'cause I'll be there can finally make it on. And I don't mind, 'cause we both know that we'll be fine when you can finally make it on. Because when I'm in a room with you, that missing piece is fine. Wasted days, summer's golden haze in our eyes. Lifting you above the breaking waves, memories floating back to my mind. You said, hold the line, I won't let go, 'cause I'll be there when you can finally make it on. And I don't mind, 'cause we both know that we'll be fine when you can finally make it on. Because when I'm in a room with you, that missing piece is fine. Because when I'm in a room with you, that missing piece is found.
Alrighty. Should we do Saturday Sun?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do it. Alrighty. Check the F. There we go. Check. That feels about right.
Sleeping alone, so tired of eating alone. I need to ask her, what's going on? Are we going strong? She fell out resting her head. My shoulder was the perfect height. We fit so right. So what's going on? 'Cause I've been undone. The long drive, the coastline, looking out at first light. Am I still on her mind? I've been undone. She put the breeze in my hair. No kiss was softer, softer than this. I'm reading her lips. Oh, each line I read. She left her books in my bed and her song in my head. I've been undone. Oh, a Saturday sun. I met someone out on the West Coast. I gotta get back, I can't let this go.
Stuff, Kelly. Sweet. I think we've got one more. Yeah, we've got a couple more actually. Well, it's been a pleasure playing here. It's really beautiful studio. You know, sometimes you play these things and you don't always get the top level sound. So I don't know. It feels good up here. That's all I'm saying. Okay, we've got two more songs. This is a new song, or been out for a couple of months. It's called Clarity. There we go. Jazz. Bit of jazzy version. Let's go with the original, not jazzy version.
The day began like all the rest, a frantic beating in my chest, a panicked reeling in my brain, perspective lost but nothing gained. I was so stuck inside my shell, and then the ground began to sway. I realized what mattered most to me when when the stars began to fall right out of the sky and the seas were rising up, I had one thing in mind. It was you, it was you, it was you. It was you, it was you, it was you. When the road began to crumble in front of my eyes, there was only one person I wanted to find. It was you, it was you, it was you. It was you, it was you, it was you. Darling, hey. The precious moments that we shared, you slowed time down inside my head. I wish I'd found this clarity while I still had you close to me. But I was stuck inside my shell, and then the ground began to sway. I realized what mattered most that day, when the stars began to fall right out of the sky and the seas were rising up. I had one thing in mind. It was you, it was you, it was you. It was you, it was you, it was you. When the road began to crumble in front of my eyes, there was only one person I wanted to find. It was you, it was you, it was you. It was you, it was you, it was you. Darling, hey.
Thanks, guys.
Alright. Let's do a little switcheroo.
Small. Thanks. Thanks, Cal. Alrighty. Well, it's been an absolute pleasure, guys. Thanks for coming, and thank you 92.3 for having us. Hope you guys have a great rest of your night. And yeah, this is Riptide.
Thank you. I swear she is destined for the screen. Closest thing to Michelle Pfeiffer that you've ever seen. Oh, lady, running down to the riptide, taking away to the dark side. I wanna be your left hand man. I love you when you're singing that song. And I got a lump in my throat, 'cause you're gonna sing the words wrong. I'm lady, running down to the riptide, taking away to the dark side. I wanna be your left hand man. I love you when you're singing.
Thanks, guys. Thanks, Kelly.
Wow. Another one, Vance Joy. Absolutely incredible. The horn was a nice touch. A nice work.
Thanks, Brad.
I think that for our initial experience here in this space, not too bad. Not too bad. A round of applause for the sound and the people who put this all together. Yeah. Thank you so much for Audacy, Vance Joy. Good luck on the album. Thank you guys so much.